one of the problems with consciousness is that the term means many different things in different contexts and to different people. But I think there's at least a consensus now amongst many of the psychologists and cognitive scientists and so on that what we mean by consciousness, the problem of consciousness, is subjectivity. There was a famous paper in 1974 by Thomas Nagel called What Is It Like to Be a Bat? And the point about that is that he chose bats because they're so different from human beings. They work by sonar and so on. But the point was, if we can say there's something it's like for the bat, something it's like to be the bat, then we can say that the bat is conscious. Whereas if, well, the bat is like a very simple robot and, you know, and doesn't, there's nothing it's like to be it, nothing for it, then we would say it isn't conscious. That is what we mean by consciousness. It is subjective experience. And as soon as you clarify that, you realize why there is what David Chalmers calls the hard problem. Because experience is subjective, private. I can tell you about it, but I can't really share it with you. You can't know what my impression of blue is, whether it's the same as yours, what my feeling of pain, none of it. It's a private thing. And yet we're saying that somehow it is caused or created by or emerges from an objective thing called a brain. So what Chalmers calls the hard problem is, how does subjective experience arise from objective things like the processing of information in nerve cells? And here you are, back to dualism. Are there two kinds of things, subjective and objective, or only one? And if so, which one? What is it? Ah, that's the problem of consciousness.